Thank you. I just said to Fran, one day they'll get to spell my name right. So we'll go from there. My mother called one night and she said, hey, not unusual for her to call me. I was in California and she was in Alaska in Juneau. You want a job in Alaska this summer? I'd been here once to visit. I thought, single mother, two young children at home. And about 1 minute later, I said, sure, what's up? My mother said they needed a supervisor and a person to travel to villages in the summer and to do Head Start physical examinations. It turns out we had 22 sheets of paper to fill out for every child in Head Start in the villages in the summer. Thank you, the feds. So anyway, not only did I have the opportunity to travel from Ketchikan to Yakutat, and then from Anchorage to Bethel, and in the Yukon-Kuskokwim regions, and then because there were two teams, had missed one, we went also to the northern areas out of Nome. I got a really great look at rural Alaska, believe me. And then they said, well, we need somebody in the office here to speak educationese. That was my language. So I got hired, and I came back and brought the family in January 1966. I was sent over to the Department of Education because my task was to take the, in 1965, Head Start was contracted to the Bureau of Indian Affairs. 1966, the state took it over, and my job was to go and convince the Department of Education that they should begin a program to educate Native people to be Head Start teachers in rural Alaskan villages, in schools, in schoolrooms that weren't yet, in the whole program. The Department of Education said, this is not our bag. And so my boss says, so do it. Well, we did it. We hired a lady who's now passed away, and we set up program. We went to villages, and the group I worked for had five of us. I was the one lady, and there were four other field directors. We recruited in all the villages and went through. The big thing was that in 1966 summer, we mounted Head Start with menus, programs, school curriculum, and we had taught and put together the whole nine yards, and with a group of other wonderful women, both Native and non-Native, and it just began. The university had no way to do anything with us. They said, well, we'll rent you some rooms for summer training, we'll feed your people, but we have no professors that know anything about this because early childhood wasn't yet, and if you want to teach people something, you have to bring people that in, and we did. And we had a group of wonderful local people and educators, and that began. Alaska Methodist took us in eventually, and now I'm really just very happy to say that all early childhood teachers that work for RuralCAP, I read the other day, are certified in early childhood, and there wasn't even a class or degree when we began. And so you can be very proud of our own state. And I think that I've been very fortunate to be able to be in a lot of places. We started a lot of adult basic education, worked with Gretchen, who's here, and we worked in other places and taught adult basic education to Native people one time. We had a group of 21, and the subject was the Alaska Native claims, and that was their subject to teach their students how to deal with the English language and how to deal with boards. We also put together a school board training for groups in the villages who never had the democracy, the value, the government in the villages at the time was consensus. We had to teach democracy and how it's done, and it was a challenge, and I've had the very pleasant opportunity to work with Paul Dixon and some of the others to do this. So I've been really in a great place lots of times, and it's been a wonderful train ride, I guess one could say. I was nominated by Joseph Davis, and I met him in one of the villages, and we've been contacted ever since. He's not here tonight. They have the flu, but thank you, Joseph. And I want to thank you, many, many, many people in the villages, wonderful people that I've met, learned from a lot. I could not sit in the steam houses with the men, but I did. I did learn a lot from women and some of those men who sat in the steam houses, took the patience to explain to me what I should be doing. And many fish I've eaten and many opportunities that I've had to be in the village homes, and I have many, many friends. And I'd like to tell you just one little story. Excuse me. I was at the, I started a book company and a publishing company because we were, I said my goal was to publish something that teachers from outside could use at every grade level, starting from preschool all the way through high school, to teach about Alaska. So not only did we publish, we contracted, I wrote, and others wrote, and so we had this opportunity. I also traveled a lot and sat in a lot of homes, and I sat in a home of a gal who was the, excuse me, who was the wife of the guy that that looked after the airplanes in that village. Her kid was running around the house all the time, and I finally said, look, you got to get this kid some shoes on, and you got to get him to school, and then you can go to school, because she told me she wanted to be a Head Start teacher, but couldn't, because this kid was home. This particular day, and we talked about this a lot, this particular day, I was in the Sheraton Hotel, and along came this, I did it! I thought, oh my God. And here was this lady running all the way around the top of the Sheraton Hotel, and she came, gave me a big hug. She said, he's in school and he's doing well. I got my AA degree and I'm a Head Start teacher. You know, and it didn't make any difference, a lot of the things that happened, but that's what really made a difference to me, you know. And then another day, one little story is that I traveled in 1965 with a new dentist, and we picked up a doctor and a dentist and a nurse all around the bush, and so every team went in, and a lot of times the doctors held evenings, and that's another story, and so forth. Anyway, two beers and another story will get you a lot. Anyway, and so, but this dentist was a really neat guy, and he rose up in the ranks of the public health, and the public health system had never, ever looked at well children who were less than in the first grade, never, and we had said, you got to do that because our Head Start kids have to have some help. So I was invited to a meeting to say a few words, and so he stood up and he said, after this, he said, I believe that we should be serving all children in Alaska, the public health service should be serving all children in Alaska before they get to school and in their preschool years. There was a silence because all this room was full of the brass, you know. Finally, the big brass stood up and said, I think he's right. Let's do it. You know, that's another thing that happens. So because of Head Start and all these things that happened, it was just, it's been a lot of fun. And I really thank Joseph and the people who are here. I have a family here. I have two families here. My son from the East and my adopted family, my son Scott and my adopted family, the Scots, and some other friends from here and there and everywhere. And I thank them for coming. And I thank all of you because you're honoring women who have not only allowed Alaskans to survive, but to thrive. Thank you.